historically that had been the place where you'd have the family gatherings. Then there was a point when those activities just kind of moved to other locations. Now we find that those folks are coming back.
This is a special place, and we wanted to be part of kind of the rebirth of Belle Isle, and it's happening.
In order to compete for talent, we need to offer not only a thriving business environment, challenging and interesting work, but a thriving community in which our people can be engaged. Having a park like Belle Isle really allows us to highlight the opportunities that exist here in the city.
You can't talk about what the city of Detroit has to offer and leave Belle Isle out of it. It's just got to be part of the conversation.
Great cities have great places to recreate. When you think of New York, you think of Central Park. When you think of Chicago, you think of Grant Park. And how lucky are we in Detroit to have Belle Isle Park in our backyard? But it needs a lot more help. And even though we've invested $13 million from the Grand Prix perspective with our partners, it needs a lot more help in that.
2015 was really a year of planning and engagement for the Belle Isle Conservancy. We're undertaking several planning processes. One was with Albert Kahn and Associates for the cultural campus area. We need to address near-term fixes to those buildings. And then we've got to look at the long-term. We're taking care of two 100-year-old buildings with decades of deferred maintenance. We expect the cost to really bring those buildings back to where they ought to be in today's standards to be somewhere in the neighborhood of $35 million.
While we're not going to plop down that hundreds of millions of dollars in one day, the money we're raising in terms of the conservancy, the money that the DNR is bringing through grants, the money that the private sectors are bringing through, like the Grand Prix, is very measurable, and you're seeing a big difference.
To know that our role in the Chevrolet Detroit Belle Isle Grand Prix is helping rebuild this island, we think that's really special.
When you think about Detroit, think about the state of Michigan, there's probably no other city or state where public and private communities come together.
We're also working with Biederman Redevelopment Ventures on a planning process that will provide us with a really robust public-private partnership between the Belle Isle Conservancy and the Department of Natural Resources. We want to create something that really looks to the future and takes care of this park in perpetuity.
Well, the Michigan Department of Natural Resources has done a wonderful job. And with the limited resources the city had, it was difficult. But the core competency of the Michigan Department of Natural Resources is to take care of our state parks. And they're doing a wonderful job with that on Belle Isle Park.
We've got 13 restrooms open, running. We're at the stage now where we are going into more of a green program with the restrooms. You go through the picnic shelters. We've made just tremendous work on those items. One of the new items that we have on Belle Isle Island for 2016 is the new canoe kayak launch. It opened in April. We know that that's going to be a great, great asset to the island. We actually took both of the fishing piers, north and south, and we actually are in the process of putting out brand new fishing piers in those areas.
And the aquarium continues to expand its hours, as does the Dawson and the Belle Isle Nature Zoo, and the conservatory is this marvelous place now. That's where the momentum begins to pick up, and that's what we're seeing. But mission's not accomplished yet. We have a long way to go.
One of the other things we're doing this year is an assessment of the Scott Fountain, which is really an iconic place on Belle Isle. It has 1925 technology, so this is going to be a project that costs in the millions of dollars to upgrade it and to really get it working so that people can enjoy it every day.
There are a lot of things that are in store, and of course they'll contingent upon us raising money to be able to complete all the plans.
Any company or any individual that's considering making an investment on Belle Isle, my message is do it.
Well, it's been a philosophy of Lear's to support the communities that we do business in anywhere in the world, but Detroit's our hometown. And for us to support the gem, the jewel, Belle Isle is very, very important because we think it's important to Detroit's resurgence.
It's really about the hope, the pride, and the happiness that you can see in the faces of the visitors today.
There's the bones of the city and the infrastructure of the city, but the heart and soul is recreation. The heart and soul is Belle Isle.
Why wouldn't we all band together and help restore it to what it really can be and show the world that Detroit is back?